Dear friends, today we will see permutation and probability. What is the difference between the two? Are they same or they different? Obviously, they are very different. We will see the difference. Consider three tennis balls and five cricket balls. White balls are tennis balls. Three white balls are there. T1, T2, T3 and five cricket balls. Red balls are cricket balls. C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5 are there. How many ways we can take any one ball from the eight balls? You know, obviously, eight ways. So there are eight balls, so eight ways. So I'm using T1 or T2 or T3 or C1 or C2 or C3 or C4 or C5 balls can be taken. So therefore, eight ors are there. For each or, I am putting one plus sign. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 8 times 8. That is eight ways. Note that we are using plus sign for or logic. This is very, very important. Note down always. Now, how many ways we can take either a tennis ball or cricket ball? Please note, I've used only or here, therefore addition. You know that a tennis ball can be taken from three tennis balls in three ways. A cricket ball can be taken from five cricket balls in five ways. So we have said or, therefore 3 plus 5, 8 ways. Same as this question, answer is 8 ways. So whenever or is there, we have to add. Now consider three tennis balls and five cricket balls, same as before. How many ways we can take one tennis ball and one cricket ball? Please note the logic I'm using is and. You know the answer for picking one tennis ball from three tennis balls is 3 and one cricket ball from five cricket balls is 5. Now, for each tennis ball I take, there are 5 ways of taking a cricket ball because there are 5 cricket balls or this. C1 or C2 or C3 or C4 or C5, therefore 5 ways. If I take T2, there again 5 ways are there, right? If I take T3, there again I can take one cricket ball in 5 ways. Therefore, totally there are 15 ways are there for this 5 ways, for T2 5 ways, for T3 5 ways, 15 ways are there. What I'm doing? I'm doing multiplication. So for cricket ball, there are 5 ways. For tennis ball, there are 3 ways. And is very important because I'm going to use tennis ball and a cricket ball. Tennis ball 3, cricket ball 5, and this I have to multiply. Therefore, 3 and 5 multiply, I'll get 15 ways, right? See. Here, there are 15 ways of selecting a tennis ball and a cricket ball. Now, what is permutation? Permutation is an arrangement of all or part of a set of objectives with regard to order of arrangement. When I say with regard, with due regards, right? It is significant. Order of arrangement is significant. A, B, and B are different cases. Example, how many ways we can arrange two letters from a set of three letters, say A, B, and C? Now we can have AB, AC, BC, or I can change the order AB to BA, CA and CB. So ABC, I can take any one letter in three ways. So A, B or C. If I take A, there is two ways of taking any one letter from the remaining two letters B and C. Similarly, if I take B, there are two ways of taking a letter from A and C. Similarly, when I select C, I have two ways of taking a letter, one letter from A and B. Therefore, there is 3 ways here, there is 2 ways here. So 3 into 2, 6 ways, totally 6 ways, as I have explained here in detail. Now, we will see case studies. Suppose tossing a coin. You know, if I toss a coin, it will either fall head or tail. Total number of events is only 2. So probability of getting a head is 0.5 because total 2 occurrences, one occurrence is one half of that. So T is occurring one times. So one half of the total occurrences. So P is equal to 0.5. Total occurrence is 2, head occurrence is 1, or tail occurrence is 1, right? Either this or that. And the answer is P plus Q, say probability of head falling is 0.5. Probability of head, tail falling is 0.5, as you can see it from here, right? Okay, coefficient of P is 1, coefficient of Q is 1. So total event is 2. So 1 by 2. So probability of head falling is 1 by 2. Probability of tail falling is 1 by 2. Total is 1. The area is 1, right? Now we'll see another tossing of coin 2 times. This is called binomial distribution. When you do the Bernoulli trial multiple times, that is called number of trials. When you increase the number of trials, it becomes binomial. Please note, the total events are 4. Head can fall in the first toss or tail can fall in the first toss. When the head falls, first toss, second toss, head or tail may fall. Similarly, when the tail falls first toss, head or tail may fall in the second toss. Therefore, total of 4 events. I am representing it as a binomial distribution. P plus Q to the power of 2. Why I am taking 2? Because 2 times I am tossing. And the answer is, an algebraic expansion will give you P squared plus 2PQ plus Q squared. Okay? So no tail falling, that is 0 tail falling, 2C0 is 1. 2 tails falling, 2C2 again 1, Q squared. 1 head and 1 tail falling, 2C1, which is 2. Therefore, this is nothing but the combination. The coefficient is nothing but the combination. So NC0, NC1, and NC2 for tails. Therefore, 2 heads falling is 1 by 4 because only one time it has occurred. 2 times tail falling is 1 by 4 because only one time it has occurred, 1 by 4. This is what is obtained by the coefficients 1 by 4, 2 by 4, and 1 by 4. So the coefficients gives you the number of ways you can get the favorable events. Here, I am putting it in another way, graphical form. The first toss, head or tail. So here, head or tail, therefore, 2 ways. And here again, for each case, head or tail, 2 ways. So 2 by 2, 4 ways. So total is 4 ways. 2 by 2 is equal to 4 ways. Now we'll see here, case study 3. Tossing of a coin 3 times. Now I learned to put P plus Q to the power of 3 because coefficient of 3 is 3 times head falling. Or 0 times tail falling. I will take it as tail falling. So 3C0 is 1. 3C3 also is 1. So 1 and 1. So probability of the 3 times head falling is 1 by 8. Because total occurrence is 8. Here again, 1 by 8. Probability of 2 heads falling. Or probability of 2 tails falling. Or probability of only 1 head falling. Or probability of 1 tail falling. Or probability of only 1 head falling. Again, it is 3 and 3 because you can see here 3 ways. And you can also find out by 3C1 and 3C2. Either way, you can take it. If you are going to take it as head, 3C2 and 3C1. But normally, we call from 0 to n, right? NC0 and ending with NCN as the coefficients, right? Therefore, I'm considering it as tail falling. 0 tail falling, 1 tail falling, 2 tail falling, and then 3 tails falling, right? That is what we are getting it here. Now, case study 4, tossing a die for 2 times. So there are 6 sides. So first toss, it can fall 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So 6 ways. Similarly, toss 2 also 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 can fall. Therefore, 6 ways I have written here. Total number of ways is 6 by 6, 36. I have given all the combinations. So 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 1 and 3, like this here. And similarly, 1 and 1, right? 2 and 1, 3 and 1, 4 and 1, 5 and 1, 6 and 1. Because first toss is on the black here, black row. Now we will see how many times the same number will fall, first toss and second toss. So here this is 1. 1 will fall here in the first toss, second toss also. Here again, toss 2 also 2. Toss 1 also is 2 here again. So it is a diagonally it is falling. So 6 numbers are there. 6 times it can fall. So probability is 6 out of 36. The remaining numbers are different. First time if it falls one number, the same number will not fall on the second toss. That is 30 times are there because 6 we have excluded. Same numbers. So the remaining is different numbers. So probability is 30 by 36. This is how you are determining the probabilities. Case 5, one more problem, 2 more problems we will see. Consider a multiple choice test attended by RK. There are 10 questions with 4 options for each question. What is the probability that RK will answer all the questions wrongly? I will consider it as a rightly also. How many questions I have to rightly answer? 0 questions. Because totally 10 questions are there. I have to answer all the questions wrongly. That means I have to answer 0 questions rightly. So we will take that way. Let x be the number of questions answered correctly. Now, for each question, there are four options. Therefore, what is the probability of my answering it correctly? Only one question out of four. Therefore, 1/4 is the probability of my getting the right answer in each question. So I'll put by definition of probability, this is right. Total events, denominator, numerator is favorable event. Now here x is equal to 0. Number of trials is 10 because 10 questions are there. And p-value is 0.25. So probability of x is equal to 0 is given by 10C0, NCR. No? The previous slide we have seen, no? For tossing of coins, we have expanded binomially and then got the coefficient as NCR. Here, instead of R, I am using X, NCX, 10C0, P to the power of 0X, and Q to the power of N minus X, 10 minus 0. So you can find out the answer for this. Next question also we will see. We will try to get the answer in Excel just in one click. Consider a multiple choice test attended by RK. There are 100 questions with four options for each question. What is the probability that RK will answer 25 questions wrongly? I will rephrase this question. 25 questions wrongly means 75 questions I have to pick correctly. So the same way, x is equal to 75. Number of trials is 100 because 100 questions are there. And probability of getting the answer right is 1/4, 0.25. So the probability for x is equal to 75 questions correctly is 100C75. 0.25 to the power of 75 into 0.75 to the power of 100 minus 75. All these things we can do it in Excel. We will see whether we can do it. Remember the words. See, first question is right answer should be 0. Number of times is n. Probability of getting a right answer is 0.25. So answer is 0.056. Right? I've done it by two different methods. This one gives directly. All you need to do is binomial distribution. You'll have to put. And then here I will put the second answer. 75 questions I'll have to give correctly answer. 100 answers, 100 questions are there, trials. 0.75 is the probability of getting a wrong answer, right? I have to get 25 questions correctly or 75 questions correctly. We will see this here. So 25 questions wrongly means 75 questions correctly I have to write, right? We'll go there. So it is 0.25. And then there is 0.75 equal to, I'll review it, 0.75, right? So this is the thing. Or I'll put 25 questions and I'll change this here. 0.75 is the probability of favorable event and 0.25 is the probability of getting the other. Same answer you'll be getting. And similarly, here also I can put 10 answers and I'll change this as 0.75 and 0.25. So either way, you'll get the same answer, 0.05 is the probability. Okay. Now we'll go to the next slide. Binomial distribution. What do we mean by that binomial distribution? There are only two outcomes in each trial. Either head or tail, pass or fail, right or wrong answer, right? That is what we are doing it. And repeated number of trials are studied. Tossing the coin so many times or writing the questions, so many questions you are answering or so many times you are playing the game. Now, constant probability of success. Probability of head falling is always 0.5 or probability of getting a right answer out of four choices is 0.25. That is always constant. And how do we represent this binomial distribution? This is how we are representing. This will give you the answer directly in an Excel. This is what I have done in the Excel sheet. Put binomial, you can put a dot, or in the latest Excel, you can need not put the dot. DIST, binomial distribution, open bracket. X is the favorable events required, and N is the total number of trials. P is the probability of success of this favorable event occurring in each trial, and zero you have to put. If you put one, it will give the cumulative distribution, right? So if I say x is equal to 10, then if I put 0, probability of answering only 10 answers correctly. If I put 1 here, then I will get the answer for probability of answering 1 answer, 0 answer, 2 answer, up to 10 answer, right? For 10 questions, if I put x is equal to 10, I will get the answer as probability of 1 because I can answer either 0 questions correctly or 1 question correctly or all the 10 questions correctly one of these things have to happen. Therefore, total probability is 1, and that is what we will get in Excel also. Now, what is mean? Mean is if there are 10 tosses and head is tossed, probability of head falling is 0.5. Therefore, I will get 5 times head MP. This is what we know, right? This is what the formula here, N times P, probability of getting the right favorable event in one trial, number of trials. Then you will get, in so many trials, you will get what you wanted. Now, standard deviations we will see later in detail. What is the summary so far we have seen? Permutation, what it is we have seen. It is an arrangement of all or part of a set of object with order taken into consideration, with due order, with due regard to order. Order is significant. AB and BA are different. Combination is, I have said, selection of all or part of a set of objects with order not taken into consideration. That means AB and BA are considered as only one event. AB and BA are same. Now, probability is different. Probability is the possibility or impossibility of selecting all or part of a set of objects, right? Okay. It is between 0 and 1 here, whereas it will be greater than or equal to 1 here. The values of permutation combinations will always be greater than or equal to 1. Whereas the values of probability will be between 0 and 1. That completes my teaching today. Hope you have understood all. In case you like it, please share it with your friends. Right? Thank you very much. Thank you for patiently hearing. I'll stop the share here. Subscribe so that you can get more videos. In case you tell any subject, mathematical subject, I'll make a special video for you and upload it here. Thank you.